Good morning and welcome to episode 9 of the Lakeland 100 training series. My name's Stephen, this is Film My Run, let's get into it. Today we're going to be reviewing what the goals are for the Lakeland 100 and then looking at race specific training. So what running am I doing which is going to prepare me for the Lakeland 100 terrain? That's what's coming up. First we have to look at last week's training. I started on Monday doing 20k, so 10k nice and steady on the seafront in the morning, and then 10k nice and steady with Zwift at the community run in the evening. On Tuesday we had the Film My Run 500 in the morning. If you haven't seen this before, the Film My Run 500 is a 500 meter climb. It's 4.2 kilometers in distance, but we set the treadmills at 12%, which means that for every 1 kilometer we run, we climb 120 meters. So over 4.2 kilometers, that's 500 meters of climbing. We try and keep the heart rate low. It's not a cardio session. It's a muscle session for the calves and the quads. Then in the evening, 9 hilly miles with the running club outdoors. Wednesday was a tough session. I did the Wednesday workout on Zwift, which is 11 kilometers in distance, but it's got 7K of kind of over threshold and under threshold intervals. So I was doing 15 kilometers an hour for 600 meters and then 400 meters at 14 kilometers an hour. Managed to complete the actual reps themselves, but the intervals, the last two, I just had to walk in between because I was so hot and tired. But anyway, we got it done. Thursday saw us doing the Film My Run 500 again, and then Thursday evening bagged that badge. So that was about 9 kilometers. I think we did 10 kilometers actually, bagged that badge. So that's about 14K for Thursday. Friday was another double day. So in the morning I did 18 kilometers flat on the seafront, nice and relaxed, filming the Lakeland 100 series video. And then in the evening I did 9K ZLDR recovery run on Zwift. Saturday was another hard effort. So I had the interval session on Wednesday, and then I did a hard, fast 5K on Saturday morning at Park Run. And then we did an easy 9K in the evening on the treadmill. So that left Saturday as a very easy day. I only had to do 12 kilometers in order to make up my full 120K target for the week. So 12 kilometers on Saturday, and that was my week done. So overall, I did 70 kilometers indoors on the treadmill on Zwift and 50 kilometers outdoors. And if you look at heart rate zones, well, in zones 4 and 5, because I did 2 hard efforts this week, I've managed to get up to 8% in zones 4 and 5. But just for fun, let's break it down in 2 other ways. So in terms of the number of activities I did, let's have a look. I did 12 activities, 12 sessions. 2 of those were hard efforts. So as a percentage, that's just over 16% at hard effort. And if we do it in terms of distance, I did 120 kilometers of distance. 16 of that was hard efforts. So 14% of my running was a hard effort this week. Look at it how you want. It's fun to break it down sometimes like that. So last week, a few people asked me what my goals are for the Lakeland 100. And I realized I hadn't said anything about it since the first episode, which is up there if you want to watch it. I am looking at the Lakeland in the same way as I looked at the Arc of Attrition. Most people who've done both the Arc of Attrition and Lakeland seem to finish it in a similar time. So I'm reckoning if I can do it in a similar time to Arc of Attrition, that is 30 hours. So my goal for Lakeland 100 is to finish it in under 30 hours. Now, from what people tell me, the first half of Lakeland 100 is more difficult than the second half. I've just been stung by nettles on my leg. The first half is more difficult than the second half. Still, I think, you know, if I can get the first half done in 15 to 16 hours and then the second half in 14 or 15 hours, let's see. So race-specific training. If you know the lakes, you'll know how gnarly it is. So lots of rocks, you'll have some fields, you'll have some bogs. Even in the height of summer, there are some places that are going to be wet. You'll have long, steep climbs and long technical descents. So what am I doing that's mimicking that kind of terrain? Well, if you want to mimic it almost exactly, well, you'd go to the lakes, wouldn't you, and recce the course. You would go to Scotland, maybe somewhere around Kinlochleven and Ben Nevis. Maybe you'd go to Snowdonia, or you'd go to the Brecon Beacons. Any of those places will have similar terrain. So it just so happens I am going to one of those places. Next week, Victoria and I are running UTS, the Ultra Trail Snowdonia 50K. That is going to be almost ideal conditions, ideal terrain to mimic what's going to be found in the Lakeland 100. But here in Sussex, we also have some pretty gnarly terrain sometimes. This is very loose rock, similar to what you might find on some of the Lakeland trails. And this is on the South Downs Way. So of course, there's going to be a lot of elevation in Lakeland 100. And so I'm trying to get in at least 1,000, preferably 2,000 to 3,000 meters. That's about 9,000 feet of elevation gain every week. So between 5,000 and 9,000 feet of gain a week, just to prepare my legs for the incline, but also for the descents. People often forget about how much you need to train your quadriceps for these descents, so that in the Lakeland 100, my legs aren't completely trashed by halfway. So the best thing we have down here on the south is the South Downs. They're absolutely beautiful. The hills aren't huge, but some of them can be technical enough to provide a decent simulation of the Lake District. It's never going to be perfect, but the South Downs is a pretty good stomping ground. So another race specific thing is time on feet. The Lakeland is going to take me at least 30 hours to do. Hopefully a little bit less, possibly a little bit more, depending on how things go. But I'm trying to spend about 10 to 12 hours a week on my feet, but the UTS 50K next week, that is going to be about 10 to 12 hours on my feet in one go. So excellent time on feet experience there. I'm also relying on a little bit of past experience, so I know what I can do, I know what I've done before. So despite the number of miles I do each week on the treadmill, I am keeping up a lot of outdoor mileage. I'm keeping up a lot of trail running, a lot of gnarly running, a lot of uphill and a lot of downhill. And it's all going to help, even the treadmill running, keeping pace, keeping a good time, keeping a good rhythm. All that is still going to help with the Lakeland 100. So if you've got a race coming up, it's well worth checking on the terrain and the conditions and the environment that you're going to be running in. Firstly, are you going to run on the flat or is it going to be hilly? Is it on tarmac? If it's hilly, what are the hills like? Are they nice tarmac hills or are they boulder hills that you've got to climb up? What time of year is your race? Is it in winter or is it in summer? Makes a difference to the kind of kit you use, the way you train. Is it going to be hot or is it going to be cold? What kind of clothes are you going to be wearing? Is there any portion of your run that's going to take place at night? So it's worth testing your head torch and going for a night run during your training. All of this affects how your training goes and what you plan to do in your training block. And if you haven't seen the rest of the Lakeland 100 series, then click on this link just here and that'll take you to the playlist. Otherwise, we'll see you next week for episode 10 of the 100 series. And we'll be ramping it up to 130 kilometers. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe and we'll see you next week. Take care, bye-bye.